Hello, this is the documentary of a thing I like to call dick history. Now you might wonder, what is dick history? Why is it called dick history? Well, I'm going to take it over to Nurse's Drip at the Statue of Angelo, and he's going to give us a rundown on what dick history means.
So this right here is where dick history first started, back in the Greek times, when small penises were actually considered desirable. Surprisingly, before all these women got fucking greedy. This is right here, Michelangelo. He made David. I couldn't find the statue of David, but as you can see, this guy has a very small penis, and it was actually considered desirable in their time because it showed self-control, intelligence, and was considered a beauty standard, and people with big dicks were seen as rude, had no self-control, and usually the people with big dicks were Vikings who would come and rape the women in the village, but those women liked it. Also said in Greek times that people who had big dicks were considered part human and part animal. And when they said part human, part animal, they meant part horse.
So as myself explained, dick history is, well, the history of dicks. But it's not just as the history, it's more of how the standards have changed over time. Because you go back to ancient Greece, where small dicks were seen as more desirable. Women like, 2 inches. 2 inches was fine, but nowadays, if you don't have 8 inches, the only women you're going to be able to fuck is midgets. Now, I'm not saying, I'm not trying to diss on midgets, because, hey, the midgets do be thick, though. I'm not finna cap with you. The midgets got more ass than most bitches out here. But sometimes when you fuck a midget, you feel like a pedophile. Like, they're 2 feet tall. But we're going to go all the way back so you can fully understand dick history. We're going to go all the way back to where it first started. Ancient Greece. It's 323 BC in ancient Greece. And you wake up and something in your pants is hard. No, it's not somebody's big toe. No, it's not a water bottle cap. It is simply your penis. And you think to yourself, why is my penis comparable to the size of an infant child? But there's nothing to fear. That is simply normal. Even further than that, in ancient Greece times, having a small penis wouldn't just be considered normal, but more considered lucky. Because people who had smaller penises in ancient Greece were considered higher social status. They were also considered more intelligent, more smart, more respectable, and overall just wealthy. But you're probably asking, why were small penises desired around that time? Because our society is pretty much opposite. Well, I ask you this, what do all of the Greek god statues have in common? No, it's not their super defined abs and muscles. It is about their muscles, actually. But it's the muscle in their pants. The one thing all those statues have in common is that their penises are bigger than mine. Like I was saying, all the statues have, well, small penises. They look like a really fucking fat Tic Tac. So, since all ancient Greek gods had small penises, they became desired. And I don't know if they were exactly desired by women. I don't know if these women, like, actually had good sex or not. That's still unanswered. But, back then, women's opinion doesn't matter. It doesn't matter if they like the sex or not. It's whatever. Or, you can take the better route that I would like to take and say that people in ancient Greece just didn't fully evolve. Because the way evolution goes is, you start with gorillas and then you go up to cavemen or whatever. What if they just never evolved from gorillas? They got every trait and every, characteristic of gorillas they evolved from, except their penises. Because they just kept the same penis size. And if you don't know what a gorilla's penis size is, go Google it. It's not. You would think it's big, but it's not. I ain't finna say too much, but if someone offered me $1 million to be raped by a gorilla,
tell them to bring me my money. Yeah!
There's tons of Greek god statues that were made in Greece, but I think we need to just go over a couple. You got the first one right here, just the classic one everybody knows, the Statue of David. And then we go to a little bit different one that not a lot of people know about. But right here, as you can see, it looks like this snake is trying to have its way with this guy. There's actually three. It's the weirdest orgy I've ever seen. Yeah, we're just gonna go to the next one. Right here is what I really want to talk about, because this guy, small penis, he's got pecking probably 1 inch. And he's getting treated like a fucking king. He's got bitches massaging his feet, kissing his hand, feeding him grapes. If I tell a woman I have a 2-inch penis nowadays, they just laugh at me. They laugh at me and treat me like I just fucking did the crate challenge, got to the top crate, and then just busted my ass and fell on my neck, and they laugh at me. I was born in the wrong goddamn time. What the fuck? So, well, then you ask yourself, why were big penises seen as less desirable in Greek times opposed to now, where big penises are seen as more desirable? What changed the narrative? Well, the only thing that changed the narrative is the reason big penises and how they were introduced, as in the form of rape. Because Vikings introduced them. Weirdly enough, I don't know how Vikings got big penises, because they're pasty white, and Greek people are darkening them. That's besides the point. But they would come into these villages, they would raid them, they'd take this stuff, and they'd rape the women. And they all had big penises. Still don't know how. So that trauma was embedded to them, and they really only liked small penises. The mystery of how Vikings got big penises and where the genetics came from, that still stays a mystery that I cannot answer. But hey, like, on the low though, like, I would get way more play if there was Vikings still. Like, low key though, Vikings aren't even that bad of people. Like, if they just came in and raped all these bitches in America, boy, I'd be fucking so many hoes. I fought with the Vikings, man. I fought with them. But now we leave ancient Greece behind, and we go to where history progresses. 1930s, the jazz era. Also known as the year women figured out they have a cervix. So, weirdly enough, the history of dicks actually, right now in this segment, is going to tie into the history of weed and racism, and I'm going to break down what I mean by that. So, in the early 1900s, a bunch of Mexican immigrants came into America, fleeing a political unrest in their country. So they came here and they brought a bunch of what was referred to as marijuana by Spanish people, but you know, it's marijuana, same thing. And eventually these immigrants, well, they popularized it and everybody was smoking it. Now at that time, that was allowed because weed wasn't even outlawed yet. Weed was used back in the 1800s medicinally, and you know, for remedies and stuff, and it was good, and there was no laws against it. It was legal to sell and it was legal to smoke. Good old days. But then the problem with weed became when it started messing with the white man's white woman. And what I mean by that is, when weed became popular, these white women would smoke this weed, and they would smoke it with black guys, and they would usually listen to jazz. And you know, at first they were like, oh, I don't like black guys, and I don't like big black cock, fuck BBC. But they smoked that weed, and when they say fuck BBC, they mean literally. It attracted them to black men and lots of famous white women and actresses would run away and just go fuck black guys. And unsurprisingly, the white men didn't like this. Their needs were not getting met. They weren't getting any fucking pussy, bro. For women, the decision between fucking a white guy and a black guy was kind of like, hey, do you want a fun size Snicker or do you want the whole Snickers bar? So obviously the white men couldn't compete. And then at that point, the white men started panicking. Like, what are we gonna do, man? We need some fucking pussy. I haven't got pussy in 7 days. I've been jerking off to pine cones that look like pairs of titties. What do I do? Well, they started doing propaganda. They started a campaign that they called Reefer Madness. So basically, Reefer Madness was a propaganda campaign which worked extremely well. One of their main selling points of it was that it was harmful to the youth, that marijuana was a gateway to heroin and morphine use, and it was violence inducing, and that it came from the devil's garden itself. The guy who really started it was Harry Anslinger. Harry Anslinger took the scientifically unsupported idea of marijuana as a violence-inducing drug, created or connected it to black and Hispanic people, and then created the perfect package of terror to sell to the American media and public by emphasizing the Spanish word marijuana instead of cannabis. He created a strong association between the drug and newly arrived Mexican immigrants who all popularized in the United States. He also created a narrative around the idea that cannabis made, his words, darkies, or black people, forget their place in society. He pushed the idea that jazz was evil music and created by people under the influence of marijuana, and also said that Mexican immigrants were rapists. I'm gonna just go back. He said that jazz was evil music. Bro, it's 2021. And when I'm making this documentary, I have to listen to the jazz music from back in the day, like, that's currently playing. This shit goes hard. I'm evil, bro. This shit goes hard. This shit is a blessing to my ears. Real shit. And in the campaign of Reefer Madness, they even went as far as making a Reefer Madness movie. Here's the trailer.
These high school boys and girls are having a hop at the local soda fountain. Innocently they dance, innocent of a new and deadly menace lurking behind closed doors. Marijuana, the burning weed with its roots in hell. In this film, you will see the ease with which this vicious plant can be grown in your neighbor's yard, rolled into harmless-looking cigarettes, hidden in an innocent shoe or watch case.
If you want a good smoke, try one of these.
You will meet Bill, who once took pride in his strong will as he takes the first step toward enslavement.
Of course, if you're afraid.
Come on, Bill! Come on! Come on! Smoking the soul-destroying reefer, they find a moment's pleasure, but at a terrible price. Debauchery, violence, murder, suicide, and the ultimate end of the marijuana addict.
Great bastard.
Hopeless insanity. See this important film now. Before it is too late.
So shortly after the propaganda in 1937, weed became outlawed. But it was too late for the white man. The BBC, that black cock, is just taking over white women's bodies and there's no going back. Like they say, once you go black, you don't go back. And it's not surprising, because black people gave white women something that white men could never give them. Stimulation of the cervix. White women didn't even know they had cervixes until about 1936. They didn't know what that wall back there was. Matter of fact, they didn't even know there was a wall back there. They didn't even know that it stretches. But once black people came in, they stretched that motherfucker all the way out. They stretched that bitch 8 inches back. They pushed that motherfucker back. They pushed the cervix all the way up to that bitch's heart. But it was too late for the white men. And then around 1950, they passed an act that it was mandatory that you get in trouble for getting caught with marijuana. Up to 5 years in prison and a $2,000 fine. Which nowadays, $2,000 fine ain't shit. But this was 1930. That's basically like me having $1 million bond in 2021. Then as history goes on, you know, the rates of African Americans being prosecuted for weed was significantly higher than white people. It even lasted all the way up to 2010. But that was all Kamala Harris. But we shall move on to the next part of history. The next attempt for the white man to get some pussy. The sad, sad white man. So the white men regrouped for about a good 60 years to figure out, what's our next plan? How are we gonna secure this white pussy again? And then one guy had this idea, why don't we make a pill that will make our penises big so we can be as good as the black men? Then Pfizer made what we call nowadays Viagra, and then it was FDA approved in 1996. But that still didn't work. It was only temporary. Black people had taken over at this point. So their next attempt was rape. I'm joking. I don't know if it was rape. I know there was definitely rape by white men, but I don't know if it was like between the years 1996 all up to now. But there was definitely rape in between this storyline somewhere. I'm just not sure where at. But that was definitely an attempt. And that still didn't work either. Now we go to 2011. Now we enter 2011. Great times, great music. 2011 was the first time we actually got a study of what average penis sizes look like and got an idea of what an average penis is. But still, in women's mind, there is no such thing as an average penis. It's either big or small. And if you don't believe me, think about a scenario. You're at the bar and a girl comes up to you. She asks, is your dick big or small? Do you think she's really going to take the time to say, is your dick big, average, or small? There's no such thing as average to women. It's big or small, that's it. So the average penis size study was conducted in 2011, and it came out that the average flaccid penis size was about 3 to 3.6 inches. And the average erect penis size was about 5.1 to 5.3 inches. Yes, sir, we made it in there. Didn't think I'd make the cut, but I'm very proud of myself. So then from 2011 to 2019, we just keep the same standard of big dicks. Usually the standard is really kept because of porn. Like, have you ever seen a guy with a small dick in porn? It feels weird to watch, right? Like, weirdly realistic. I mean, weird to watch. Because every guy on Pornhub just has, like, a fucking 13-inch Florida Everglades python boa constrictor. You know what I'm saying? So, time goes on, and, you know, girls, like, you know, small penises are used. It's like, oh, you got a small dick. It's like an insult and just widely used. And a lot of people lying about their penis size. Like, niggas was in sixth grade talking about, oh, yeah, dude, I'm fucking packing 13 inches. First of all, Connor, you're white? That's not possible. Two, bro, you don't even got a mustache yet. You got some peach fuzz, okay? Don't try to come over here with some fucking peach fuzz and tell me you're packing 13 inches, especially if you're not fucking black. So, you know, it goes on, history progresses. If you don't got a big dick, you know, something. Usually, people who have the belief that only big dicks are, like, good is usually people who are not that sexually experienced. Because you look at, like, older people, like, 20, 23... Even milk, they really don't care. They know that if you like, you kind of like take your time to progress in sex, and you have sex like a couple more times, you know. And even if you're good at eating pussy, yeah, then the sex will still be good. You just kind of had to hit that G-spot. A lot of different positions to do that. Anyways, so then you get to about 2019 where we were saved and TikTok came out. About a year into TikTok, girls, men, everybody kind of started exposing their secrets that the opposite gender really didn't know. Lots of them. Lots of crazy stuff I learned there. I just learned about a coregasm. If girls are doing like core workouts in the gym and it's like really good core, they can just orgasm. Yeah, that's crazy. Anyways, so girls are exposing their secrets, and a lot of girls are coming out saying that like 5 is like perfect for them, and you know, average is fine, and that girls really only say they like big dicks or have sex with big dicks just so they can just like kind of brag to other girls. I totally believe it, because I've heard a girl who bragged about her sister only fucking guys with like 8 to 9 inch dicks, like and told me that. I'm like, okay, what the fuck, like, is that supposed to be a flex or something? Like, you see, obviously, he's trying to brag about it. Like, fuck are you telling me that shit for, nigga? So, we really learned that it's only really just as a stunt. And I know people with big dicks who have said that, yeah, girls are like, oh, yeah, I can handle that. And then they don't never come through. So, we really learned that it's kind of just a stunt and a flex. And that it really don't matter. Especially if you have some personality, some pussy eating skills, and you can't be ugly as fuck with a small dick. You can't have 20 bad qualities, okay? You can't beat up women, have a small dick, fucking look ugly as shit like a goddamn gargoyle, and you know what I'm saying? You gotta have a couple good qualities in there. And then 2020 comes. Actually, I think it was 2021. And we get an article, I'll put it up on screen, that there's actually pollution is causing dicks to be smaller, which is both good and bad. Because we're not at a point where it's 100% like, oh, small dicks, average size dicks, small, fine. Still kind of like, you know, the big dick standard. But we're definitely moving into a different direction, and it really don't matter if you got a good personality. But this is kind of bad, too, because it generally is about lowering testosterone. If you have lower testosterone, it's going to affect dick growth. So lower testosterone is not good. There's tons of things that make us have low testosterone. We don't want that. That's why people wear fucking skirts and become gay, because they have low testosterone. That's why they wear their skirts with their makeup and their nails painted. So that's not good, but at the same time, it is not that part, but the other part of it, that dicks are going to get smaller. But here's the conclusion I'm coming to. I want you, the person listening to right now, if you stand with me and you want the standard of small dicks to just be regular and normal, all that, I want you to take as many fucking straws, a truck full, a plane full, a goddamn, as many straws as you can get. And just throw them in the ocean. Don't give a fuck. Don't think about no goddamn turtles. Don't give a fuck about the goddamn turtles, okay? I will fuck those turtles with my 1-inch penis. Who cares about those turtles? Just throw it in there. Because if our dicks are all small, then they really don't have a choice. You know what I'm saying? Like, they don't have a choice. And the second thing I want you to do is, if you have a small penis, no bigger than 6. No bigger than 5.5. I want you to go and just donate as much sperm as to a fucking sperm bank as possible. As much sperm. Build it up for 2 years and bring a whole, like one of those huge gas cans. Those huge gas cans that you have to put in a backup truck. Just bring it to them. Just bring it to them. And then we'll be good, man. I guarantee your kids are going to get a lot more pussy than you did in your generation. They won't have to go through the, like, oh damn, I'm not gonna get no pussy because my dick ain't even gonna touch the surface. Nah, they gonna get hella pussy. So I want you to fucking cause as much pollution as possible and donate as much sperm as possible if you want to make a change with me. And that's the end of dick history, all the way from ancient Greece to now. I think history is gonna progress, though. I think there's definitely gonna be some changes that are happening. I think we're moving in a good motion for right now, on that specific subject. Everything else, the world is crumbling, but that specifically, we're doing great, but the world is crumbling. But I think we're gonna do good. There's gonna be some changes in the future. I even think from 2 to 3 years from now, things are gonna be totally different, or just moved from how we're doing right now. But that's dick history. That's the history of dicks. That's how it was. Wanted to share that with everybody so they know. Have a great day, and remember, fucking put those goddamn straws in the ocean. My dick, sick and dangerous. Yo dick, quick and painless. My dick, enough said. Yo dick, love spread. It's time that we let the world